Looming over the Sussex countryside in southeast England stands this colossal structure, shrouded in scaffolding and seemingly abandoned mid-construction. Once said to be the biggest private house built in Britain for over a century and called by some the Devil's Palace. Hamilton Palace, as it is in fact named, is not some grand stately home that has fallen on hard times, but rather the work of a modern property tycoon whose reportedly shady business dealings funded the construction of a rural monolith, built with 3-foot-thick walls to last, according to its owner, for thousands of years. Nicholas van Hoogstraten was the man that in 1985 set about the construction of this imposing private mansion standing in 100 acres. From the ruins of a nursing home that once stood on the site, until work halted in the mid-2000s at a cost of £40 million. From the ashes rose this hauntingly unfinished house of monumental proportions that he intended to house his private art collection, apparently for now stored in Switzerland. Named Hamilton Palace, reportedly after the capital of Bermuda, where Van Hoogstraten owns property, this neoclassical pile features a copper dome even larger than Buckingham Palace. This notorious edifice is so large that it even features its own marble mausoleum, intended for Van Hoogstraten, and by using the palace in this way means his trust would legally own the buildings and their fittings in perpetuity when he passes. A large portion of his wealth has been transferred into a Bermudian trust for the upkeep of historic monuments. Under English law, perpetual trusts are only allowed in the upkeep of monuments and graves. The eerie-looking palace has found itself at the center of more than one controversy with the local community and authorities. It's reported that there was a long-running legal battle over a public right-of-way over the land that resulted in Van Hoogstraten blocking paths with razor wire and a pile of discarded refrigerators. When neighbors called for the property to be put to good use by helping the needy, Van Hoogstraten allegedly called the idea ludicrous, saying that even the most moronic of peasants could see that the grounds are being landscaped. Little further work on the project has taken place since Van Hoogstraten fell out with his architect in 2000. For now, the controversial palace continues to stand empty and really seems to deserve the name it's gained in media, the Ghost House of Sussex.